Welcome to another Vinyl Voyage. I was thinking this evening we talk a little bit about backmasking and reverse speech. And what they are, basically when you play a song backwards, you hear a message. Reverse speech is just kind of incidental. It's basically, you know, you play a song backwards, and if you really listen, you can kind of make out certain words. Reverse speech is not intentional. By comparison, backmasking is when you intentionally take a song or a lyric or some piece that's spoken forward, reverse it, and insert it into the song. And in the 70s, 60s, and 80s, you had elements of both. I think it became most famous initially with the Beatles, with the number 9 from the White Album. If you play it backwards, it's supposed to be Turn Me On, Dead Man. So I want to talk about two bigger examples. Now, the first one is Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven, all right? Maybe we can play each one and you can get a sample of it here. So this album was released in 71. Years later, some busybodies during a hysterical period came to the conclusion that this is some kind of satanic verse within Stairway to Heaven. Is there any merit to it? Well, we'll give it a listen and you decide. We'll get to that in a second, but in my view, it's just simply reverse speech. That's what Led Zeppelin says, that's what Robert Plant said. Jimmy Page just kind of laughed about the whole affair. So that we'll listen to Stairway to Heaven backwards in just a minute. But I will give you an example of actual reverse speech. This is Electric Light Orchestra, Face the Music. It's the album, it's from 1975. But the example I'm thinking of actual backmasking is from the song Fire on High. It's the intro. If you've ever heard the song, it kind of sounds a little bit garbled. It sounds kind of like the voice is kind of fading as the song plays. It doesn't exactly make sense, but we'll explore it here in just a minute. You guys can decide what you think. Welcome back to our Vinyl Voyage on backmasking and reverse speech. So the first we're going to give a listen to is Fire on High by Electric Light Orchestra. It's off their 1975 album, Face the Music. A little bit of an electric chair there with what appear to be headphones. Interesting, I guess they want the condemned to enjoy some music. So we'll give this thing a shot. So, Fire on High, I think it's first song. So we'll give it a play here. Let's see if I can reverse this thing. So, this isn't exactly a manual turntable, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug the power source here. Gently. Now, I'm going to drop the tone arm. I'll try to reverse it here for us and we can see what it sounds like. Alright, so a little hard to get the exact speed on this turntable, but I'm going to try to reverse it for you now.
The music is reversible, but time... Turn back!
Did you catch that? We'll do it again here. All
right. So this is backmasking. It's a clear message in reverse.
The music is reversible, but time.
So that is actually a little bit of a cheeky message, because if you keep reversing it, you go off the edge of the record. So a little bit of a sense of humor with the whole backmasking hysteria here by Jeff Lynn. All right, let's try the more famous example, the famous from Zep 4, Stairway to Heaven. The imagery also is a little bit interesting. You've got almost appears to be a Star of David being held up as a lantern over a village. Let's give it a listen. Now I unplugged the turntable so I can turn it backwards, so it's going to take me a minute to figure out where exactly to cue it, but I think I can do it. So I think we're at sort of the infamous part. Let's give it a listen backwards and see if you hear anything. Did you catch it? I'm not sure if I did, so let's try it again. Forward. Oh, come on now. He's not a fan, is he? We've got an audience today. All right, buddy, hop down. Come on. We got the sensors coming in, stopping me from playing. Cued to the bustle in the hedgerow portion of the song. This is where the busybodies went wild. Let's see what we can hear. We'll play it forward first. Pretty innocuous. Let's go backwards.
You
not sure if I heard it. Want to try it again? Forward. Here we go, one more time. I don't know.
So what are your thoughts on this one, folks? There were certain people who were adamant that there were secret messages. It probably didn't help that the album had sort of these runic symbols on it. And of course, Jimmy Page was famously into the occult, so it probably helped fuel some of those rumors a little bit. Now, I think there's an element of... I think that there's a little bit of persuasion, and I think that people can be... You know, if I were to present certain lyrics to you, you'd hear those in the song. And if I were to give you different lyrics, you'd hear those as well. So just as an experiment, that's why I play the song backwards with one set of lyrics and then the other, to see if you notice the difference or if one sounds clearer than the other. In the case of Fire on High, there's no ambiguity. It's a backwards message. Well, thank you. Signing off from the basement, the retro basement, another Vinyl Voyage. I'm glad you could join me. Good night.